This week at Interior. Secretary Jewell this week joined Agriculture Secretary Tom Vilsack to announce the National Fire Preparedness Level has been raised to 5. That's the highest readiness level for wildland fire operations. Right now, more than 60 large active wildfires are burning across 13 states, and nearly 20,000 interagency personnel have been mobilized. Both secretaries highlighted the growing threat of catastrophic wildfires in drought-stricken areas of the West this year. They called for reforms in the way the federal government funds wildfire suppression efforts. More than 39,000 wildfires have burned nearly 6.4 million acres in the United States this year. Secretary Jewell traveled to Ohio and Wisconsin this week, pressing home her support for full and permanent funding of the Land and Water Conservation Fund. She joined Cleveland Mayor Frank Jackson at the city's Rivergate Park to announce $42 million in grants to states for promotion of outdoor recreation and conservation. The money in the Land and Water Conservation Fund comes from offshore federal oil and gas leases and has helped pay for more than 40,000 projects nationwide. The landmark law is set to expire this year without action from Congress. Check out the interactive map of Land and Water Conservation Fund project sites at doi.gov/LWCF. The latest listening sessions this week hosted by the Bureau of Land Management regarding the federal coal program. Those sessions took place in Billings, Montana and Gillette, Wyoming. The listening sessions look to seek out information about how BLM can best carry out its responsibility to ensure American taxpayers get a fair return on coal resources managed by the federal government. The next session is set for next week in Denver and Farmington, New Mexico. The Fish and Wildlife Service this week announced more than $3 million in grants to help conserve native fish species and their habitats. The grants are going out to 18 partners in 34 states to help stem the decline in native fish populations by protecting and maintaining aquatic ecosystems and preventing further degradation of fish habitats that have already been damaged. The Fish and Wildlife Service says 40% of North American fishes, some 700 species in total, are in peril. Find out more at FWS.gov. Anchorage, Alaska this week joined the 50 cities taking part in the Department of the Interior's Youth Initiative. 50 Cities is an ambitious program aimed at connecting a new generation to the great outdoors by inspiring millions of young people to play, learn, serve, and work on the nation's public lands. Last week, Salt Lake City, Utah joined the 50 Cities program. Locally, the program will provide 2 years of funding for the YMCA of Northern Utah to upgrade public lands, facilities, personnel, and participation in outdoor programs. And you can call them the GeoGirls, 20 middle school students from Washington and Oregon who took part in an outdoor program put together by USGS and the Mount St. Helens Institute. The girls spent 5 days doing hands-on research, interacting with scientists, educators, and older students, and learning about volcanoes, natural hazards, and modern scientific monitoring technologies. The GeoGirls program goal, a stronger understanding and connection to Earth systems, and inspiration for the next generation of scientists. That's this week at Interior.